Jesus said already in Matthew chapter 7, verse 6. Take your Bible and let's go there and find something. Matthew 7, 6. And I'll show you something. Matthew 7, 6. Those with the digitals, you are almost there than I am. Now, what's the name? Stand and read boldly. 7, 6, please. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
Are you there? Okay. If you are there,
Matthew chapter 7, verse 6.
Yes, please.
Do not give dogs what is sacred.
Are you listening? Don't rush. Take it one by one. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do not give
dogs
mm-hmm.
what is sacred.
Mm-hmm.
Do not show your bills to pigs.
Mm-hmm.
If you do, they will trample them under your feet
mm-hmm.
and then tear you to pieces.
Good. You can sit down, please. He said, don't give dogs what is holy. That means if you are giving something to someone, watch who you are giving to.
Yeah.
Don't just give gift to anyone, anyhow, because you are compelled to give a gift. Just saying that.
Yeah.
Paul said, it's a blessing to give than in receiving. He was quoting from Jesus. But Paul did not say completely what Jesus said. Jesus is now saying the other side of the coin. Who has a mint or a coin here? A coin. A coin. Every coin has how many sides? Two sides. The front side is the giving side. The other account is the receiving side. So every coin have both sides. Jesus said, oh, watch out. There is more blessing in giving than in receiving. But don't give dogs what is holy. And don't give pearls to pigs. No pearl. Pearl is one of the most expensive ornaments that women wear. They are so round bulges. It's very expensive. Some of them can cost millions of dollars. That's what Oprah Winfrey was saying here on TV. $16 million of pearl. They are going to give this kind to a swine or a pig. Pigs are animals who live in mud and they like dirty things and stuff. They will not value it. They are going to trample that expensive stuff. And that is not even the issue. After doing that, the Bible says, verse 6, the last verses, the sentences, lest they trample them under their feet and turn and tear you up. There are some people who are very ungrateful. After giving something to them, they will turn around and then they deal with you drastically as if they don't know you. But when he was sick, I went there, it's okay. But on the fire that I bought for something special, this guy does not have anything to remember. No, you forget the good things you did. That's what he's talking about. It's not everybody that you give people.
Yeah.
No. If my daughter here is 5 years, I can't go and buy her a tablet of 800 euro. I won't do it. For what? She can put it in 3 days. Papa is capori and I'm ending. It's my show. I should have bought the plastic one in
action.
Save you the 50. Yes. By the time she is 15, 16, you know the value, then I step to the next level. That's what he's saying. But let me put it to you today that most of us here are like that, including me. Including me. Until God gave me this revelation. So I'm going to share it with you so that you know how vulnerable Christmas is. Christmas is not just eating and drinking. No. It's not just going to shopping here and there. No. Shopping spree. No. That's not what Christmas is all about. No. At all. Christmas is not just a matter of, it's end of the year, let me go and give him kadoche because last year he brought me kadoche. Nay. Christmas is not all about this decoration we see. No. It's nice. Christmas is not all about this case boom that you do with lightings and shining. No. No. But what is Christmas? Christmas is God giving to man. Christmas is divinity giving to humanity. Christmas is light giving to darkness. Christmas is forgiveness giving to sin. Christmas is life giving to death. So it's always what? Giving. 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 But don't forget the other side of the coin, the receiving. We can get the gift from God all right without receiving it. Amen. So, let me hit here. This is the kadoche that God has given to the world. The gift is not the bow. The gift is not this ribbon. The gift is not the papier and the Vatican. You understand me here? The gift is not a container. Are you following me? The gift is not the papier and the Vatican. Why am I speaking this? The gift is not a wrapping paper. It's not the ribbon. It's not the container. But what is the gift?
It's inside.
It's the one inside. Amen. John 3:16. Who can say John 3:16? Let's all say it together.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life.
Whosoever believe in
him.
Whosoever believe
in him.
Did you say the word in?
Yeah.
In him.
Do you say the word in?
Yes.
Where is the kadoche?
In him.
We have received Jesus, but we forget to open Jesus. We are so much busy with the box that we forget the content. When we come to church every Sunday, Jesus, you are my Lord. He said, represent the Vatican, the box. He says, you are beautiful. He says, you are the King. He says, you are mighty, oh my Lord. I'll bow down to you. I worship you, Jesus, the box. Without thinking of what is inside the gift box. That's what we are. So we have become like pigs that God has thrown pearls before us. We are going to trample over it. We have become like dogs that nothing holy should be given unto us. But God has given Jesus. But when Jesus was born, the angels came and announced. He said, a king has been born. They didn't say Jesus has been, he said a king. So the content is what? The king, the Christ. Some time ago when I came here, I taught you that you see that you are of two parts. Your bottom count and the inner count. Netherlands, come on. Your spirit lives in the inside and your flesh on the outside. That's what Jesus was. Jesus was the outside box. And the content is the Christ, as you rightly said. So when Jesus was coming, he too brought a gift. So I call it gift of the gift. God gave Jesus as a gift to you and I. But when Jesus came as Christ, he also had a gift. And that gift is what? You can tell me what it is.
Life.
What?
Life.
No, not precisely. Yes.